You know, I was talking to Brad Pitt one day, and he was like,
"What's in the box?"
This is everything I bring on a typical drone shoot. This is a Pelican, I think it's like a 1510 case, in order of unpacking. That is my CrystalSky monitor. On every shoot that I do, I always bring two identical drones. All right, so this is a Mavic 2 drone. Now, they have the Mavic 3, but that's a $4,000 drone. And if I have to buy two of them, we've got a controller for each drone. It helps having two controllers because if a lot of times my producer or director wants to actually see the shot that I'm getting, so I can hand them a remote with an iPad or a... Anyway, we got batteries for the CrystalSky. We've got the mount for the CrystalSky car charger. We've got the typical four battery Mavic charger, this one, and then the CrystalSky. This is a four-way, I don't know what they call this plug, but it's the plug that goes into your charger, to a type A plug. You know, it's my combination extension cord and power strip. It just saves a little space. When in a car and I only can use a car for power, I'll sometimes use this. This thing doesn't charge batteries as fast as this, which is why I'll bring a 200 watt inverter with me. This stuff is called camera wrap, and this is by Rugged. I like it because it gives the drone a little padding. It also helps the propellers and the props, they're the same thing, not get caught on anything. I buy these bags from Home Depot, maybe Lowe's, I don't know. But they're cheap, they're not made for photography, they're actually affordable. In here, I just have a duplicate USB wire for everything that I might need. I've also got one variable ND, and I've got one set of filters. One row of these filters are polarizer filters that are ND, and also just regular ND. I've got extra props in here, but also my little homing beacon, and this gets packed underneath the plane. It just helps me kind of know where the thing is. Keep in mind, if you put your drone on a plane, the batteries have to go with you in the cabin at all times. My white balance card, memory cards. I actually have two memory card cases. One case doesn't have anything on it, the other one's a shot. You've already probably figured out why I do that. It's also if anyone tries to steal your drone, you've got nunchuck. No, you don't, that's stupid. Pretty much stay in the air all day with six batteries, given that I have a charger nearby. Got a sun visor for my CrystalSky. I don't use TSA locks anymore on these things. They'll take them off, they just don't put them back on, or they'll throw them inside the case. Usually what I do is I leave one of these notes, and the note basically says, could you please put a new zip tie on when you're finished? Anytime I've ever had this box searched, I've never had the TSA agent not do it. On my drones, you see these little red stickers. These little red stickers are not the FAA number. Although I do register my drones and I keep my registration with me in case I ever ask. I get these stickers made up from a company called ID My Stuff. It has my name, my phone number, and my email address on it. I have a flyaway, or I leave equipment behind or something like that. If I have my TSA number on there, no one's gonna look at that and say, oh, let me call the FAA and find out who this belongs to. Oh, if you want extra credit, radios. We used to use phones, but that's just a pain in the butt. I'd rather just throw a radio in the cab and say, hey, when I tell you to go, go. When I tell you to stop, stop. It's just faster. But there's no room for me to keep them there, so I put them in another bag. I don't know if that was helpful for anyone. If it was, let me know. If it wasn't, you probably are not even watching it this far. So anyway, this is John Sullivan from the Sullivan Studios. Thanks for watching.